Game 9 of the NRLSA All-Stars Carnival, brought to you by VInet Solutions.
Kicking two, Zach, or not?
And airing right here on Spacequake Sports. This is the last match. Doesn't really matter much, but you already know who our two grand finalists are going to be. It will be the Pacific Islands versus the Indigenous All-Stars. But this matchup, however, we've got New Zealand considered very much a favourite.
Behind the kicker.
They were. They formed a little bit. To be a favourite for the day. The same with the British Isles. You know, I had them as my underdog for the day. And, it's unfortunate. Look at this.
Look at the speed
look
on that
Look at this return.
Up.
Look at those
That's
hits.
A massive return. So both of these teams have one draw, one loss.
But the way that the New Zealand teams come out, it's like they are still playing for a spot in the final.
Well, that's how you need to play. So the New Zealand All-Stars with an exceptional opening drive here, making plenty of yards, and they are looking very threatening.
Tackle. Right side, right side.
So they've actually, they had a bonus tackle before. They just had five called, but they're only on fourth. So now they've...
Line!
All right, so a bit of confusion in the tackle count going on there, but...
Big pass.
Big pass
over
out to the wing.
Try time.
Put it down. So huge opening drive. 1 minute, 10 second try. I think that's equal with our best.
Well, I actually reckon that's actually faster.
Just sneaking in?
Yeah, I reckon the last one was about 1:40, and this one's come out at 1:10, so...
So a very fast try, scored off of their opening drive.
And it's funny because they were both from the New Zealand teams. So they've definitely got the pace there to get on the board pretty early.
Another big thing, they actually connected with their wing, which is something that they have been struggling with.
That's a lot of teams have been struggling with that throughout the course of the...
Well, the other one which has struggled the most with their wing has been the British Isles.
Exactly.
In fact, they actually probably would have had a lot more wins under their belt if they actually were connecting with their wing a bit better.
Oh.
Especially against, for example, the Riverlands. Well, both of their games, actually. If they connected with their win, then British Isles probably would be... leading this particular pool. But at the moment, it is the New Zealand All-Stars. Kick to come. It's a good-looking kick. It crosses over. That's a big kick there for the New Zealand All-Stars. And it is 6-0 in Game 9 of the NRLSA All-Stars Carnival. Game 9 of the NRLSA All-Stars Carnival. We are watching the New Zealand All-Stars face off against the British Isles All-Stars. New Zealand with possibly the fastest opening try for the game so far. And British Isles, they're not going to be happy with being in this position.
No.
Stay behind!
There's a lot of fight and passion in that British Isles All-Star team.
Now, with the kick here, is possibly one of the best players in the Metropolitan competition, Zach Patch. Probably a contender for the best and fairest. And he's very much been leading this team.
Hands out, hands out.
So far, good defensive work by the British Isles. They're getting numbers in the tackle, slowing down the play of the ball as best they can. Look at that. Good tackle. Nice and low. Push him back. This is an excellent defensive set so far by the British Isles. Good little pass there.
Here goes the New Zealand
numbers
All-Stars
on the wing
again.
Good hustle again from the British Isles, getting them down.
Five, you're off. Keep coming back, five.
So New Zealand All-Stars moving the ball well, once again looking quite menacing. Big passes out to their wing, and they've got plenty of numbers out there.
Oh. That's something we haven't seen. They've done that twice now. You know, their first couple of games they played, they couldn't connect with their wingers. And now all of a sudden they've just managed to gel in the right areas across the course of the field, connect with their wingers and their centres, and convert it for tries.
So this is an early lead stemming out for the New Zealand All-Stars with a very similar play to their first try as well. Both coming off of very, very long drives. The British Isles defense was looking like it was working the treat early on, but then just a few too many meters gained. So 5 minutes into the game. Now, although that's a lot of points for New Zealand to stack on early on, at the same time, all I can think of is giving plenty of time for a turnaround to happen inside this game.
You might be thinking of a turnaround. I'm thinking of seeing whether they're going to break the points score.
The points record.
Which was set by the Pacific Islanders.
22 points is the most points scored in a All-Stars game.
Was 20 points by the Australian All-Stars when they locked out the World All-Stars.
So you're thinking that possibly this could be a blowout?
I'm thinking we could be looking at a blowout, and unfortunately the kick was missed there.
So 10-0 as we're just over 5 minutes into the Game 9 of the NRLSA All-Stars Carnival. Welcome back to the NRLSA All-Stars Carnival. Now, I think one of the biggest things that we've had, this British Isles All-Stars just haven't really had the opportunity to control the ball offensively at the moment.
No, they haven't really, have they?
And at that, they tried to get something going. They just want the ball in their hands, give them a chance to do something. But instead, they've got to put on another big defensive set against these very, very large New Zealand boys. There's a lot of size difference going on between these two sides. So third tackle, New Zealand, about 45 metres out from their try line. A turnover, an error, something big, but instead they're connecting with their wing.
New Zealand, they just seem to be connecting well with their wingers this time.
Ah! Make it on! Make it on!
So right away, New Zealand.
25 metres out, they've managed. No, 15 metres out, sorry.
Oh, good little offload here.
They go to that wing again.
Has to cross them over the line, and it absolutely does. New Zealand moving the ball amongst their side perfectly, working well. This is a side that we just didn't see earlier on in the competition.
Watch out for that score record. I reckon it's going to be broken. Not even halfway through the game yet, and we're on to 14 points.
So while the British Isles All-Stars have not had much opportunity to really control the ball, to make any real kind of offensive play, the New Zealand have just been going from one end of the field to the other.
And they've been ferocious with it as well.
They've been doing it without the help of penalties as well.
That's right.
That's what they're calling you, didn't you?
Good old-fashioned rugby league.
So another conversion coming in. Just slowing the game down a little bit here.
Just over 8 minutes gone in the game so far, and all New Zealand. If you're a British fan.
So this is the fastest lead that anyone's, 8 minutes, 30 seconds in, already 14 points up.
Kick to come. And the kick, that's as straight as you can get.
Beautiful kick. So New Zealand All-Stars leading 16-0 against the British Isles. You're watching the NRLSA All-Stars Carnival. NRLSA All-Stars Carnival, Game 9, the last of the pool games. We are watching the British Isles versus the New Zealand All-Stars. And, British Isles managed to make something happen. It was a short, low and fast kick from Zach Patch. Just a little bit too hot on the incoming for the New Zealand All-Stars. And
that's the first time he's managed to pull that off, that kick. He's done it twice before. and it hasn't really come off. But this time, it has paid off, and this is going to be our first real look at a British Isle attack.
Heads in, second row. When you're ready.
So a nice simple scrum.
One day, Zach Patch with the first run. Off him, let him go.
First tackle, 10 metres, 20 metres out. Oh, the ball is bobbled. First opportunity that they have to make something happen. Second play, bobble the ball. Things are just not working well for the British Isles All-Stars in this ninth game.
No, they're not. And it's a shame, actually, because, you know, as I said at the start of the day, they were my underdog team for the day.
So they... putting in a bit of fight in the scrum there, but really getting much of a turnover opportunity.
Hands out!
And once again, the New Zealand All-Stars working the ball well, running the line. Second tackle and just another huge drive. They're just making yards after yards.
I don't think you would want to come lining up against a few of these blokes if they're making yard after yard like they are.
It's a lot
Look
of
at
momentum
this.
To stop. And
sneaky passes. There they go. Over the line again. Here comes that score record.
So New Zealand All-Stars putting on a monstrous total early in the game. They are at 20 points. A conversion here will equal the largest total in this NRLSA All-Stars competition.
And quite possibly in history.
First offload mid-tackle, second offload mid-tackle.
And at the end, that was just made to look too easy. Not sure what's going on with the British Isle team, whether they've failed to turn up or they've just fallen asleep or what's going on.
I think this New Zealand side has just finally actually started
finally
connecting.
Woken up, yeah.
Yeah, they're performing...
Too little, too late, unfortunately.
They're performing at the level in this game that we were expecting them to be performing throughout the competition.
Absolutely.
At the same time, this British Isles All-Stars is possibly one of the smaller teams that we do have.
Yeah.
Again, one of the problems with the competition is that, you know, teams are formed not out of... filling positions, but obviously running along nations of origin. So, you know, you'll have teams...
Unfortunately, the kick was unsuccessful there.
So you'll have teams filled entirely with wingers, and then you'll have teams filled entirely with...
Front rowers.
Mm. And, you know, it can create some rather interesting matchups. But in this case, I think that there is a rather large size difference working between the British Isles and New Zealand, especially when the New Zealand are they're rolling well and they're not making unforced errors.
No, that's exactly right.
I think just the amount of work that it's taking the British Isles to kind of stop and then slow down this New Zealand onslaught is what's really kind of creating the problems.
So let's see whether Zach Patch is going to do another one of his little clever kicks again.
It'll be a clever kick. Look at that. Nice little clever kick. And this one looks like it's going to work.
Oh, it's worked. What's going to happen there?
I think he knocked it on.
Yep. Unfortunately, the kick was on, and it just unfortunately just didn't work out the way they wanted it to. And it's a more relaxed-looking New Zealand unit this time. They don't look stressed out about, you know, they've got a good, comfortable lead. They can take their foot off the accelerator. They're not in a rush to pack their scrums or get anywhere. They're just out there to play football.
So New Zealand with the ball again. They have not been stopped once on their offensive charges.
No.
They have made it to the try line just off of their five tackles. No penalties helping them from deep within their defensive end. And they are possibly looking at putting on the largest score total achieved in this competition so far.
Well, they've got just under 6 minutes to achieve that feat.
So a try will do it. Once again, the momentum of this charge is just...
Have a look.
Everything's looking New Zealand's way. They're moving fast. Working the ball out to their wing.
Here they
their
go,
right wing has
out
been
the wing.
Very effective. Good job by the British Isles, wrapping up the arm, holding off from the offload. Fourth tackle, 20 metres out. big charge. He'll go down 10 metres, fifth and last. What are we going to see from the New Zealand All-Stars?
I'm going to see a sneaky kick here. Oh, hang on.
There's a whistle.
Ref's called something, picked up something here. What's he picked up?
Sloppy playbook.
Must have been something just a little bit wrong with the play of the ball. It looks like it's going to go the British Isles way.
Wait, boys.
So a handover.
Thank you.
Not quite sure what happened there.
Must have just been a bit of a sloppy play, and because it was fifth tackle, no scrum, just straight up handover.
Hands out.
And that's the first time that the New Zealand All-Stars have not converted ownership of the ball into a try.
And that was on, but they still managed to pick that up.
The ball is still alive, and the British Isles are actually making a lot of yards off of this run. Second tackle in their offensive end. Opportunity here for the British Isles. They do not want to suffer the biggest loss of the competition. This game was always about pride. And if you're going to fight for it, now's the time.
Absolutely.
Third tackle called. British Isles still moving the ball well. Trying to find a few gaps. A big stiff arm here.
Oh, there we go.
Clever little offload. And this has got a cross over the line. First time the British Isles get going and they make it all the way across the field.
And that's what the British Isles have been missing all day is once they get going, they get going. And they haven't been able to find this opportunity throughout the course of the day. And they just made the New Zealand defence there just look small. Yeah, perfect switch to play there.
The help was there.
The help was there. There wasn't any silly passing going on.
It was nice and controlled. If the pass wasn't there, hold on to the ball, take the tackle. But look at this. Reads the defensive line well, finds the gap. A soft, safe offload. I mean, with the British Isles, we've just seen too much. They're just trying to get a bit too clever. And then just knock-ons, fumbles, that kind of thing. So kick coming in. Looks like it just snuck in. It looked like it was off on our camera, but kick snuck in. And now we're looking at 3 minutes left at play, 14 point deficit.
That can't happen. I'm still waiting to see them crack this.
I think we've
got to
stop saying that can't happen in this competition. So far, pretty much anything can happen. So we are looking at a game being played for pride. It's game 9 of the NRLSA All-Stars Carnival. The championship has been decided. It will be played between the Indigenous All-Stars and the Pacific Island All-Stars.
And that's going to be a cracker of a game.
An absolute cracker of the game. New Zealand cannot be bothered.
Oh, here we go. Look at this.
Not waiting for the tee. They just want to keep this thing going.
Yeah, this is something different. Well, there you go. And what a kick that was too.
Decent kick out of it.
I think now they're all starting to have a bit of a laugh out there now.
So British Isles.
Language!
Second real opportunity to try and make something happen offensively.
Left side!
2 minutes remaining left in the game. Oh, another good run here. Just finding a couple of gaps. He's still alive.
Look at him go again.
Everything closing in on him. Hold the ball down to the ground. Got to get up for a quick play.
Hep just drags him across the grass like he was a rag doll.
So British Isles, ball still alive, and there's a fumble. Turnover to New Zealand. Hep's with the ball. He'll be happy just to hold on to it, bring it to the ground. 1.5 minutes left at play. New Zealand knocking on the door for the largest scoreline achieved in this competition.
Ref's found something up there. Incorrect play of the ball.
Yeah, Hep's just rolled it. Foot didn't make contact. So we're going to have a scrum going the way of the British Isles. So we're going to see about 1 minute left at play. Probably too much of a lead to really recover in that. But once again, this game has all been about pride.
As we see, they're all starting to have a bit of a laugh out there with each other now.
Let him in.
So British Isles with the ball.
Sneaky little pick up there out of dummy half there.
Zach
out
Patch
of the scrum.
Still alive. Working the ball well.
Oh, look at Zach Patch go.
So first tackle, and we are 15 metres out from the try line. Another good run. They're reading the defensive line really well, finding those opportunities to find little pockets of gaps that they can kind of execute into, but that definitely wasn't one of them, as he got
too little, too late,
rounded.
Unfortunately.
So as we're heading into the dying seconds of this game, can the British Isles All-Stars put one more on the board?
It's a little bit of a consolation prize.
This will possibly be the last play of the ball. Ball still alive there. It was a bit nut. Here we go. So I doubt that we'll actually see the scrum. The time has run out. And there we go. So that concludes the pool rounds for the NRLSA All-Stars Carnival, brought to you by VINET Solutions. I hope you have been having an exceptional day of rugby league here on Spacequake Sports.
This next game.
And what a way to finish. We are going to watch an absolute, I guess a ripper of a game is probably the best way to describe it. The Indigenous All-Stars versus the Pacific Island All-Stars.
Yeah.
Are going to play it off for the championship to win it all, the NRLSA All-Stars Carnival. It has been absolute magic, and we have one more game. This is going to be incredible. Stick around. Pacific Island All-Stars versus Indigenous All-Stars coming up next.